Good evening, everyone. We hope that the events conducted by the orientation team have been informative and engaging. We at NIT Tirchy value the overall development of students, which extends beyond just building a promising career. The NCC, NSS, and NSO play a vital role in the students' character development, which is an essential part of their professional lives as well. The NCC aims to shape young people into responsible citizens and future leaders of our country in all walks of life, helping them develop discipline, leadership, companionship, and courage. Over to the members of the NCC, who will now brief you about the activities of their team.
NCC stands for National Cadet Corps and is the youth wing of the armed forces. The motto of NCC is unity and discipline. Here at NIT Trichy, the NCC cadets are given military training in parades. A-Flight NCC is the air wing of NCC at NIT Trichy. There are two ways in which the cadets are trained in our college: institutional training and camp training. Institutional training is an on-campus training planned in such a way to ensure that each cadet acquires optimum benefits of the organization. It mainly focuses on perfecting foot drills, rifle drills, and theory classes. Institutional trainings gives us an exposure towards a regimental life, which inculcates the values of discipline, punctuality, smartness, and work ethics. Camp training is given by officers of the Indian Air Force. Camps are one of the most special and memorable experiences in a cadet's life. During the years of NCC, you will be mostly exposed towards civil affairs, drills, weapon training, adventure training, personality development, and leadership skills. In addition to all these, you will also be exposed towards various cultural activities like dance, group song, etc. NCC conducts various activities on and off the parade ground. Independence Day and Republic Day are two of the most important days for us. We get the opportunity to perform foot drills and rifle drills in front of the college. We take immense pride in performing these drills and are extremely valuable to the institute and the students.
Being a nationwide social service organization, we cadets take part in various social responsibility events. In Eye Checkup Camp, where students, faculties and the campus residents get a free eye checkup camps. We cadets of NIT Tirchi pay visits to orphanages every year. In these visits, we conduct games, perform plays and other fun activities to entertain the kids. Apart from this, we conduct various talks by air officials, blood donation camps and other tree plantation drives. We ideate events from scratch and then conduct them independently, which brings in leadership qualities, organizing and decision-making skills.
Driven by the cadets of A-Flight NCC, NIT Trichy, it aims to persuade and motivate the youth to join the defense forces and civil services through various opportunities. Since its ample inception in 2012, Lakshya has grown leaps and bounds every year. Lakshya offers a wide range of events, workshops, informals, accompanied by guest lectures delivered by the veterans of their respective fields. In offline, Lakshya conducted events, URI movie screening, online quiz series, Mazaran, The Question Mark, Escape Room, India Quiz, and the Aim Click Capture, and the informals, self-defense, rifle dismantling, parkour, archery, and rifle shooting.
Lakshya also offered guest lectures by Colonel R. Shivanathan sir, Lieutenant General R. R. Nimbodkar sir, and Mr. Elancharian sir. Even in the pandemic, Lakshya held up the spirit and conducted various activities online. The events Q Fiesta, Track Trial and Tail, Wheeled Visionaries, Constant Confusion and Question Mark, guest lectures by Captain Yashigal Tyagi ma'am, and various host series were proposed. The enthusiastic students participated in the activities conducted by Lakshya and grabbed the chance to grow as a person to discover the spirit of being an Indian.
For students who aim to serve the country by joining the defense forces, paramilitary forces and state police forces, NCC provides a golden opportunity. NCC cadets who hold a C certificate are permitted for SSB interview directly. There are seats reserved in Indian Naval Academy, Air Force Academy and Indian Military Academy for NCC cadets. NCC cadets are also awarded bonus marks in various government exams. In our college, cadets obtain B certificate after having completed 2 years in NCC. The C certificates requires them to attend further more camps and written examinations which test their technical knowledge. This certificate is eminently valued while applying for the defense forces. Other than these certificates, NCC cadets can avail various scholarships for educational purposes. Not only in armed forces, but also during placements, NCC cadets are looked up to and have an edge over the others in recruitment. NCC cadets also get an opportunity to take part in youth exchange program, in which they can represent India in other nations. Most importantly, NCC ignites patriot in you.
Thank you, team and NCC, for that informative introduction. Sport development is a national priority as it promotes an active lifestyle, social inclusiveness, a sense of belongingness and national pride. The NSO helps instill physical awareness among the youth. Next up is the NSO team to introduce you to their work.
Hello everyone. Good evening. Let's talk about NSO. NSO's main motive is to develop awareness about fitness in among students. Hello. NSO's main motive is to develop awareness about fitness. As NSO, NCC and NSS are the institute requirement courses, but these courses are really useful in developing among these courses, NSO is really useful in developing leadership skills, develop and teamwork and developing teamwork and leadership skills. So we have, if we talk about the facilities of the NSO, we have in our infrastructure, we have indoor stadium, Technogym, which is a 25 meter swimming pool, 400 meter athletics track, sports complex, basketball court, tennis court, Coco ground, and also handball ground. So if we talk about the teams we have in sports, we have around 17 teams in our NSO sports. We have athletics team, badminton, basketball, carom, chess, cricket, football, handball, hockey, kabaddi, kho-kho, powerlifting, swimming, TT, taekwondo, and boxing, tennis, and volleyball. So NSO generally is a part of your academics section, which helps to you to get to know about more about sports. So it also helps you to not just perform the activities in college, but also we organize some events in college and out of college also, like inter-IT and other inter-college activities. And also takes part in other events also. As for the sports teams, we take part in various tournaments, like inter-college tournaments, like inter-IT, BHU, and all other inter-college tournaments. Being in NSO will also accompany you. You are applicable for being in if being in a sports team also accompany you, that you'll be in NSO automatically, and this okay guys, next furtherly we'll answer few Q&A questions.
Thank you for those valuable insights. Next up is the NSS team. The NSS team upholds the need for selfless service and the appreciation and tolerance of another's perspective. The belief that the welfare of an individual is ultimately dependent on the welfare of society as a whole is at the core of their activities. Without further ado, let's dive into the NSS briefing session.
Greetings to everyone. I'll be presenting about National Service Scheme today. I hope my screen is visible. Greetings, one and all present here. National Service Scheme, it's a voluntary association of young people from college and other universities to serve society. We go with the idea, not me, but you. It reflects the essence of democratic living and upholds the need for selfless service. It helps the students to develop and appreciate other person's point of view and also show consideration towards other living beings. Let's have a quick look what NSS is. So the National Service Scheme is a central sector scheme of Government of India under Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. It provides opportunity to the students of India to take part in various government-led community service activities and programs. The sole aim of NSS is to provide hands-on exposure and experience to young students in delivering community service. This was the basic idea what NSS do. Now, take a quick look into what we do in NSS NIT 3G. We have a team, a social team, which ideates, organizes, and executes socially responsible events for the social welfare and well-being of the community and as well as the environment. Let's have a look at some of our events that we did. iCamps. In iCAMS, we examine people for iEnlist so as to provide them the best of the facilities and the possible remedies. We also sensitize people about eye donations, and a large number of them volunteered to pledge their eyes. We also do blood donation camps where we motivate people to donate blood. This event is done inside our campus, and it was a great success as more than 100 volunteers donated blood. We also used to visit old age homes and orphanages where we donate various necessary items from our hostels to them. And it also helps everyone of RNSS team to realize our responsibilities towards those elder members of our society, and also helps us to realize the agony and pain which these people go through in orphanages and as well as old age homes. Let's have a quick look at other events in our college. We did many events apart from those like Fit India Movement, Cyclothon, Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat, and most prominently, Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. So under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, we've also adopted 5 villages in and around our college, where we are striving to support them and help them with the necessities they need. We work in line with those government schemes to implement it in grassroots at our level in and around Trichy. We also have camps where attempts are made to improve conditions of villagers. Now let me talk about the most prominent event that NSS have did, that is India Book of Record. We conducted an awareness program for more than 28,000 students on plastic hazards awareness on 15th of October 2019 and covered more than 60 schools. This was this event which was recorded in India Book of Record, and I would like to present a video to share that. We covered Now let's have a look how NSS National Service Scheme adopted in this pandemic period and switched to the online events. We conducted various social talks such as on women health and hygiene, India after democratizing homosexuality, Austin awareness, and other camps like yoga and meditation programs, and as well as on mental awareness. So these were the social talks that we did. And during the Independence Day, on 75th of our Independence Day, we also pay our gratitude to remember unsung warriors who fought for our freedom but couldn't get much of people's attention. Now let's have a quick look on what is your role in NSS. As a part of NSS team, you will be either coming as volunteers or executive committee members. You will be helping us in ideation, creation, and successful conduct of the event. The volunteers and executive committee members form the backbone of NSS, thus an important part for all of us. Now, what NSS will provide you? There is immense opportunities that NSS can give you. Some of them I have mentioned here, which includes personality development, a great chance to serve society, a chance to improve communication skills, team working, and most important is the field work that we do in NSS. Thank you. We'll have questions at the end.
That was quite informative. Thank you. We will now have a live Q&A session. You can type out your questions to the teams in the live chat box.
You can be part of both, but it's really difficult to manage because NCC and NSO have really strict practices and very busy schedule. So you can be in both, but it's really tough for you to manage being in both. You can join NSO, choose NSO while you apply for your courses in your first year. And so it's like another course you join in. Yes, it is compulsory to join one of these three because it's an institute requirement course. You will be having access to sports, but on a specific time. It goes same like NCC and NSS. Like you can join multiple teams, but it's really hard because all the teams would be practicing at the same time in the evening. So it's really hard to manage. For you to being in two sports, like if you're in basketball and cricket, both the teams will be practicing at the same time. So you can't give full time to both the teams. So it's really difficult for you to manage, but you can join multiple teams. Yeah.
Okay, so I see many questions where people ask, is there any requirement for joining NSS? So as he said, it's an institute requirement course, but for in joining in NSS, there isn't any particular criteria required. The only thing we expect from people joining here is they need to know what is NSS and what we do in NSS. That is the only requirement what we look for candidates who are willing to join in NSS.
In NCC, we select candidates only based on their interest, enthusiasm, and their dedication towards NCC. No, there are not any physical limitations. There are some medicals, but it is not very tough. During your time in NCC, you will get certificates. After your second year, you will get B certificate. And after the camp, which you have after third year, you will get C certificate. And if you get the C certificate, then you can directly go in the interview of SSB. That is the profit of C certificate.
So I see a question where they're asking the role of NSS in events or fest. So we don't actually explicitly we don't explicitly do any job in events or fest. We have our own events and we have our own team, so we don't interfere in the fest of the college. But sometimes we do take work for the social responsibility team of Festember and Pragyan if required.
It is possible for you to represent if suppose you are in NSS and in a sports team, then only you can represent NIT in any other competition or tournament. You should be a part of a sports team and be regular to the practices, then only you can represent NIT. You can register through like course registrations. You have to apply for them, or there will be some Google forms created for this.
For inducting in NCC, you will soon have the inductions.
So there's a question where a person has asked, are all NSS members are involved in fieldwork? Yes, so every NSS member from the first year till the fourth year, they will be involved in each and every work what we do. Each person will contribute what they can to their fullest potential. So there won't be any member they'll be sitting around. Everyone will be contributing to every event what we do.
No, you can be part of the sports team. You're interested. You can be part of NSO and sports team, whichever you are interested in. Suppose you're interested in cricket, you can be the part of the cricket team. You don't need to learn about the sports overall.
As I said before, in NCC, after your third year in NCC, you will get C certificate after the camp. And if you have the C certificate, then you can go to the interviews of SSB directly. That's the profit you get.
Yeah, so there's a question where he's asked will there be any certificate given for being a part of NSS? Yes, there is a certificate given for being a part of NSS, but you need to be actively working in NSS for at least 2 years to gain that certificate. So as they explained to you, any of these three activities are compulsory for your first year. And if you again choose to work for NSS for in your second year too, you'll be eligible to get a certificate from NSS.
As mentioned earlier, you can just choose one of the three, so it's not possible. If you choose NSO, you have to continue to get NSO for 1 year, for your first year.
As we are air wing of NCC, so we follow all the rules that are followed in Air Force. So you have to get a haircut if you are in NCC.
Like, I see many questions where people are asking, like, is it compulsory to join any of these three? But yes, for your first year, it is mandatory that you join any of these three from NSS, NSO, and NCC. It's mandatory that you join one of these clubs.
If you are in NCC, then we teach you to manage time and your skills. So you will be able to manage NCC with your academics.
Yeah, I mean, it's not easy, but we learn how to manage time and give our time to both of them. So it's possible, it won't affect your academics much. Generally, all the sports team practice after the classes get over, which is 5 in the PM, or before the classes start, which is before 8 AM. No, you can't change to another for the first year. No, you don't have to be good in sports specifically. You just need to be interested and dedicated to your work towards sports. You just need to be that. As college is slowly reopening, all the second years are in college right now, and till next month, third years will also be there. So possibly we can conduct when you guys are back in campus, we all are back in campus, hopefully.
That brings us to the end of the session. We thank the members of the NSS, NCC, and NSO for the educative briefings and for offering valuable insights into their activities. Thanks to everyone watching for choosing to spend this evening with us. The orientation team has a very special event planned for you on the 19th of December. The social night event is aimed at helping you take the first step to those lifelong friendships, replete with live interactions and fun games. I'm here to inform you that the interest forms for social night, through which the registrations can be done, will be released tonight. There will be a limited number of seats available, so stay tuned, for this will be an experience that you will remember. See you there.
A very good evening to one and all. My name is Arden Kishore, and I'm a second year student of the Chemical Engineering Department. It took you all several months to get to this position, maybe even several years. A variety of tests, practice tests, mock examinations, all-nighters, coaching, and whatnot. But just in case you require a little bit more support on your march towards a better you, we have with us a representative of the State Bank of India, the manager of SBI and NIT Trichy. Ms. Lavanya will not only cover the education loans that SBI offers exclusively to the students of NITD, but will also cover the ATMs and other services available to us. So we from the orientation team strongly suggest that you stay focused till the end. Over to you, ma'am.
Good evening, one and all. For first year and hearty congratulations to you all for securing a seat in this prestigious institution. I am Lavanya, branch manager, SBI NIT. It is located inside the NIT campus itself. The branch is located inside the NIT campus itself. Now I will speak to you about SBI account opening, loans and other alternate channels like as they said, ATM, YONO, internet banking, everything. I'll just take you through. First of all, we will start with the account opening. For account opening in SBI Savings Bank, since you are in campus branch, it will be comfortable for you to have account with us. When you are visiting the campus, it will be comfortable for your operations. So for that, basic requirements are like PAN and Aadhaar card. For PAN, even if you are a minor, you can apply the PAN card. You can get the PAN card without photo. Aadhaar card, in the current address, we can open the account. So afterwards, we can change the address to your hostel address. That is not an issue. These two are the requirements. Even if you don't have PAN card, you can apply and submit it later. So with the Aadhaar, first we can open the account. This is regarding the account opening. And next, we will come to the loan part. Loan part, first, for students of NITT, there's a special scheme called Scholar Loan. And the rate of interest in this loan is 7.15, which is nearly 2.5% less than the normal educational loan offered to the students of other institute. Since NITT is coming under the elite institution, this special offer is given for you guys. And for that, the basic requirements, I will just take you through. Then what we can do is we can have an interactive sections whereby I will take your individual questions. For loan process, both your parents, that the student and the father, should have an account with SBI. Even if you have with any other branch, it is fine. It is not mandatory to have account with NITT. Your parents can open an account in their nearby places if they are not having with the SBI. These two are the first basic requirements. PAN card is mandatory for students applying loan. For both parents and students, PAN card is mandatory. And other things are like, if your parental income is less than 4.5 lakhs, you have to produce the income certificate and you will be eligible for interest subsidy from the government if you produce the income certificate. During the course period and after 6 months, till the time your interest will be refunded, subsidized by the government. And Other things are like basic things like checklist and application, we will share it. Basic things are like other things for loan are like you need to apply in Vidya Lakshmi portal. That is mandatory because all education loan applications are to be processed only after applying in Vidya Lakshmi portal. And during the course period and after 6 months, you will have a moratorium period. So what you have to do is you have to start your repayment only after 4.5 years. And next thing is like during the moratorium period, if a parent wishes to pay interest and take interest certificate for claiming IT purpose, that can also be done. And these are the basic things about loan. So we can take questions separately. Regarding any individual questions like loan, we can take it separately. And for during the course period and 4 months, you will have simple interest. After that, the interest rate will be compounded. After 4.5 years, the interest rate will be compounded. And the fee, the eligible amounts that can be claimed under loan is the tuition fees, hostel fees, mess fees, and laptop to the amount of 60,000. So this is the total amount you can claim. So based on your bona fide certificate and fee structure, which you are producing, your loan amount will be arrived. These are the things which are covered. And if you have paid the first year fees, we can reimburse to you from the sanctioning of the loan. From the next semester, the fees will be paid directly to the institute and we will give you the receipts. And these are about the loan, scholar loans. Next, regarding the alternate channels like ATM, they said once you open the account, ATM card will be dispatched to your address. And even if you are a minor, after becoming major, you can use the same ATM card by just changing the status of the account as major. And next thing, you can use internet banking, Google Pay, everything using this account. Internet banking, YONO app you can download and you can use. All the features like fund transfer and you can view your accounts low. Even if you are going to avail loan, the loan accounts also can be viewed in YONO. So you can do all the transactions in YONO net banking itself. And these are the basic things about savings, loans, and alternate channels. I will take up individual questions right now.
So, Mr. Alwas, any questions that you may have in the chat box now onwards? We'll start with the first question.
Scholarship, I think you have to apply in your college. We are giving only the scholar loan. Scholarship, you have to apply in your individual college only. Okay, when to apply for your loan? You can start immediate and you can start applying. Only when the institute starts issuing. Then next question. Okay, now as you are away from the campus, what you can do is you can open the account in your nearby branch and get it transferred when you are coming here. Otherwise, you can open the account when you are coming to campus. Hopefully, you guys will be coming after 1 or 2 months, I guess. So what we can do is when we are coming here, we can open. The same day, you will receive the passbook, ATM card, within 1 week you will receive. Aadhaar address will be there in the account. Not necessary. Not necessary to have. But for operational convenience, it is better, but not mandatory. Yes, yes. If you have any account also through ATM, you can withdraw. Yes, you will get the full fee reimbursement. Okay. I will share your, I think your orientation team members will be sharing my phone number with you. I'll also share the branch mail ID. So we will forward the application and checklist tomorrow. And once my phone number is shared, you can contact me and make the documents ready and send it by courier to the branch. So that we will process and we will send it to a nearby branch for signing of documents. Signing of loan documents has to be done before an officer. So we will send it to a nearby home branch for signing. You don't have to visit the branch. You can send it through courier. You can contact individually on this. Once you get our papers ready, like a PAN, account, and fee structure bona fide, you can start contacting me individually. Yes, yes, it is covered. Less than 4.5% subsidy is there. Not an issue. Interest rate is same for the scholar loan, 7.15. Only the interest which is applied, depending on your loan amount, will be subsidized. Yes, EPAN is enough. EPAN is enough. That's what scholar loan is for elite institutions in India. It covers NITTs, IITs and IIMs. Normal education loan is for other institutes. So you will be covered under scholar loan. Yes, up to 60,000 we will refund, but you can purchase for more amount also. Yes, yes. After 2/3 remission amount, okay. That also we can get it. The interest which is applied during the course period will be refunded. The interest amount which is applied will be refunded.
You need to use the contact details that will be provided to get any specific doubts answered. Feel free to ask any vital question you require the answer to, because we realize how important this is to you. The end of the bank session and all orientation events organized for today brings me to announce that the social night has been planned for 19th December, 6 p.m. In case you missed it, The social night is an interactive event where socializing becomes easier. In the form of blocks, you freshers will be talking about different topics and even playing several fun games together. So in case you're looking to get an edge at making lifelong friends, social night awaits your presence on 19th December at 6 p.m. Don't forget, there are limited seats available for this event. So I hope you have your phones stuck to your bodies when the interest forms release tonight. Looking forward to see you all there. Thank you all for attending today's session of the orientation program. Stay tuned to our social media handles for updates and information about tomorrow's events. Thank you.